All right, so I don't think we're going to see another button check from here on. Colonies looks battle ready. Crazy Colors just talking to the fans real quick, man. It's like, hey, what character should I go?
Now, I know these two have previously played before, but I'm not sure what was the turnout of their previous encounter. So this would be new to me. Actually, first time commentating for these two playing, actually, so...
Okay, so they don't meet in bracket very often?
Not too often. They have met in the past, but again, I don't remember the outcome of those encounters.
Okay, so it looks like we're about to start game one.
Yeah,
this is a match.
This is definitely a match. Going to town and city, either the two rows of players get that first ban, we're either going to be on battlefield or town and city. Obviously, they favor those stages because of their characters.
Right, yeah, these guys definitely looking to kill off the top a whole lot. So I think town and city is certainly a natural choice.
Right, but right now we're seeing Colony's not able to land right now. Taking 6% in the process and just fighting his way to the ground, but going back in the air thanks to that up throw coming out from Colors.
And he has yet to land even a clean hit so far. Colors just absolutely dominant in the early stages of this match. He's got Colony's with his back to the wall. Let's see. See, Fox is definitely not very apt at getting through the wall that is Luma again, because most of his hits don't knock her away. So when Rosa has stage control like that and Fox is on the edge, it's extra hard for Fox to get through without having to pick some stupid option like that.
Yeah, very desperate option.
Yeah. Okay, crosses through the pivot grab, but there you go. The weak dash attack doesn't pop Luma away, and Colors just continues this momentum.
Colony's very having a bunch of trouble trying to get in right now, get his own game started, but now with the back air into the dash attack. Clank right there, but still in his favor.
Yeah, definitely still anyone's game. Of course, Fox is such an explosive character that once he does manage to get one clean breakaway, he could end up taking the stock.
Well, most definitely. It's just he's having trouble keeping advantage in his favor, and even getting rid of Luma. That is the true problem that he's facing right now.
Yeah, this still the first Luma of the game.
Exactly. Okay, now his attacks are going to start sending Luma into tumble. There's the up air. Oh, no. Do not get thrown off the top.
Dude, Luma must have like 5 HP left. This is actually kind of nuts. I've never seen one Luma last so long. Oh, and wow, side B actually being the move to kill her.
Finally getting rid of Luma now. Tries to go for the perk pivot dash. Oh, excuse me, down smash. But the F smash doing the job instead. Able to take that stock. Is it too late, do you think?
No, not necessarily. Though Fox is very light, so he's literally... He has to survive this edge guard. Okay, cool. Colors, for some reason, choosing to commit to a forward smash, but now that he's going to be off stage with no jump, wow, doesn't even... I think he wanted to run off there.
Most definitely. Yeah. That definitely was a misinput, wanting a down air in that situation. He had grabbed him, took his jump, so he knew he was in the situation where he had to force out the up B. Still, we're seeing Colonies having trouble getting back on stage, getting stage control. He needs to do his best to get center stage and maintain it at all times, especially in a situation like this.
Wow, 164... Not a percent you typically see Fox live until, but he's able to just keep it together, run maybe like an 80% string of just up airs and repeated juggles, dash attacks to trap everything. Then he could bring this back, but he just knows every little mistake is super costly at this point, so he's going to be very careful with this risk management.
Exactly. We're seeing a lot of run-up shields and mainly using his up tilt and jabs at out of shield options. Luma almost taking the stock right there.
At 167, this man just lived what looked like Luma up air. I've seen that kill people at 20%. So I'm just letting you know.
He got lucky right there. That was more than likely the weak hit.
Yeah, of course.
And now we're just seeing, again, he's playing patient, but Luma's gone. There's the back air. He's going for the ledge trap. Just lets him get back on stage. Definitely not something he should have done.
Even a jab will definitely spell death for Colonies right now. Though Rosalina... Especially with all this rage on Fox, is getting dangerously close to kill percent herself. But even playing with grabs, you got to be careful. Forward throw should do it.
Wow, no, chooses up throw.
Whoa, I didn't know that even could kill.
I mean, it can, but you'll normally see the forward throw out of Rosalina and Luma take the stocks.
At least in that situation, you know.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. Town City, 176%, most definitely.
Yeah.
Colony's really getting bit in the butt by trying to pummel when you grab Rosalina. You got to immediately go for that throw. You got Luma waiting right there. Luma definitely can't break up that grab, and that's what happened. It really cost him right there. Should have just immediately went for the fourth throw and continue pressure.
Yeah, if you know this matchup, you know that you have to throw Rosa immediately. And I'm pretty sure that living in a state with both Carnal and Colors, Colony's has to know this matchup. Just maybe a little bit of spaghetti, just pressure's on, first game, almost making this huge comeback. What do I do? What do I do? Uh-oh. Didn't throw Rosalina immediately. Now I dropped the game. So,
right.
Yeah, Smashville for the second match here. Not necessarily a polarizing stage either way, I would say, in this matchup. Okay, forward throw, just sending Luba way out there.
Of all things, I would not expect forward throw. Now, Conley's, this is, does have more chances in this set. This best of five set. And we're actually seeing him... Excuse me, we're actually seeing Colors choose to stay on the platform, which is very smart. You're waiting for that time for Luma to come back and just a Randy up smash, getting the advantage back in his favor.
Yeah, like, hey, I'll take five lasers. I don't care. That's right. Absolutely no problem for me. It could have gotten way worse had he gotten impatient, came off the platform, and then gotten up-aired by Fox with just one of those, does 15, 16 damage, and obviously links into itself. So, yeah, sometimes you just have to sacrifice a little bit in the immediate for that long-term payoff. Speaking of, that's kind of how you have to approach the Rosalina matchup as anybody, right? Like, you have to give up some hits on Rosa to dispose of Luma sometimes.
Exactly. And oh, my goodness. Wow. Amazing conversion.
Colony's not doing that when he had that quick breakaway. Should have gotten rid of Luma, but since he didn't, he actually just took an early death.
While getting Luma out of the way isn't the end-all, be-all. Oh, my goodness. The up smash actually doing the job right there. Again, while getting rid of Luma isn't the end-all, be-all, it makes it that much easier in the matchup as a whole. So again, yeah, you're going to have to take those hits every now and then, but it'll pay off in the long run.
I mean, the character's called Rosalina and Luma. You get rid of the and Luma, that's two-thirds of the character out of the picture.
She's back down. She's down the mid-tier without Luma.
Yeah. Yeah, she actually is really not that impressive without her. You know, a frame 8 jab, just slow, generally underwhelming kill power.
Collins with the dare into the dash attack, trying to make it so that Colors cannot land, but he just throws out the nair. Works really well for him. Those multiple hitboxes. Catching Colonies.
Yeah, Fox's moves just lend to each other so well. You get one, you're probably going to get a couple more. Oh, and the platform.
Taxi platform working against Colonies right there.
Okay, they just kind of crossed each other up with Dash Shield.
I mean, it's anyone's game right now. Colonies got to get back on stage, reset the neutral, but gets grabbed. Amazing pivot grab coming out from Colors.
That was a really solid reaction, yeah.
Goes straight through the F smash. That was very, very risky side B.
Okay, he's just going to jump out of the way of Colonies' juggle trap. He knows Colonies is looking for that air dodge. He wants more up airs.
They're going immediately to the platform. Luma's back on Color side.
Oh, that was almost really dangerous. He meant to slip off the platform and presumably back air, but since he didn't manage to run off the edge, he got dash attack, almost died for his trouble. And now we've got Color still on the brink of death here.
Surprised he did not go for the back there at the ledge trump. Going to get thrown off stage. Color's just looking to down tilt this side B, and he just grabs the ledge.
I like that. Doing nothing is sometimes the best mix-up.
Almost definitely.
New.
Both of these players reactive and kind of defensive in their own right.
Oh, the frame traps on shield, though. Back air, of course, having that generous auto-cancel window. Okay, Color's rolling out of trouble. He knows Luma's coming back in like 4 seconds.
Oh, there's the up air. Oh my goodness. Just barely whiffing the up air.
Okay, and he managed to hold out without Luma until she respawns. Now it's just one clean hit from that little star, and you can say goodnight to Fox.
Right, Fox is going to have the hard time trying to get the kill in this situation. Rosalina has numerous kill options that are much easier to land. There's a forward throw coming out from Colonies.
Oh, Luma just spinning on stage that actually made it harder for Colonies to just run over and hit
her. Oh, the F smash!
Yeah.
Amazing, amazing. Catching the roll get up. Colonies able to close out that stock. It's now 1-1.
Specifically because the hitbox lingered on Luma.
That really paid them off. That really paid off for him in the end there.
Yeah. I've noticed a lot of people have taken advantage of that before. Like, okay, Rosalina's getting up from the edge, but Luma's going to be right there to extend my hitbox. You don't have to be as precise with hitting the vulnerability windows between the stand-up and being able to act.
You know, with some characters, that actually messes up what they're trying to do.
Yeah,
and
true.
Again, it worked out for Colin. He's very lucky in that situation, able to put himself on the board there.
All right, so Crazy Colors dropping that game that honestly looked to be completely in his favor. After the first stock was so fast, granted, Colonies did make an immediate response to it, but still, that was looking like Crazy Colors' game to win, and he just gave it up. Even after getting Luma back, I was like, okay, he has, you know, 12 and a half seconds where he doesn't have Luma right now. He's at kill percent. Colonies is kind of on fire. He managed to get through that, but he couldn't close the deal. So now we have a 1-1 set, and it's going to be Colors' counterpick. Of course, if he wins here, he gets counterpick advantage for the rest of the set as well, so this is huge for him.
I was just about to say, probably going to Battlefield or Dreamland. Then again, it wouldn't have been bad to run it back to Town and City. It benefits both characters, just like this stage benefits both the characters.
Yeah, I think this stage actually is a little bit better for Fox than for Rosa, in my opinion. Just because, you know, Fox doesn't care about necessarily cheesing an early kill on you, whereas Rosalina almost needs to sometimes.
Oh, and yeah.
The higher ceiling on the stage really is going to set her back in that regard. That said, she is extremely dangerous in the neutral because of the platform layout, so it might make up for her reduced kill power here. Whereas Fox, of course, everyone knows, on Battlefield, Fox is disgusting.
Exactly.
Because those up air ladders get that much easier.
You see Colors going for up airs in this situation. Probably going to even use the platforms to his advantage when he does choose to continuously up air colonies.
Yep. Unfortunately, Rosa just doesn't have that vertical burst movement like Fox does to get up and down and up and down all over the place. But no. She can still definitely make his life very difficult coming back to this ground.
And we even see that right now. Colony's trying to find a way to land. Able to land on that side platform. And we're still seeing him at a disadvantage right now. He's forced to approach and go in. But Game Pass Luna is just going to be so difficult for him.
Yeah, and especially, actually, exactly what we saw before on the edge, how Luma has extra hit lag added and kind of lingers hitboxes.
Ooh, and that lingering S smash going to do that to Colony's recovery right there. Jeez.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's definitely a problem for Fox when he makes contact with Luma with, say, neutral air or dash attack. It doesn't knock her away, and then Rosalina actually gets extra frames to make contact with Fox. You know, so just Luma being a body block is really, really detrimental to Fox's game plan here.
Right, and it's very risky to go for the jab attempts right there. Jab gets rid of Luma as well, but if Colors is the shield that gets a me grab or dash attack punch, whatever he chooses.
Oh, I feel like Colors had a super easy grab there. He just needed to wait for Colonies to land from the downer. Like, he had the read, he just didn't commit to it. And sometimes, you know, not committing is what gets you, and sometimes the opposite.
Again, being a defensive player, he normally doesn't commit, especially with Luma gone. He's going to wait. He's going to pretty much take his time in that situation.
He was so close to landing that.
Jeez.
That definitely would have killed. 70% with some charge on it.
All right, down smash gets grabbed instead. Oh, the down smash. Oh, my goodness. Down smash coming out from Conley. So he's not going to be able to recover. Conley's sitting at 81%. He can definitely bring this back. As you mentioned before, Fox being a burst character like he is, definitely cannot count him out of this.
That was such a rare, like, looking down smash. You know, you don't normally see it happen like that, but it did. Was that up tilt or jab 3? It
looked I believe that was jab 3.
Okay.
I don't think I've seen the halo come out from Rosalina.
Right, right. I felt some extra gusto behind it, though, which is the only reason I asked. Yeah, okay, it was.
Okay, it was up tilt. Yeah. Yep.
Oh, it was up tilt.
That was up tilt. I seen the halo come out on Rosalina.
Yeah, sorry. I'm just watching Luma because that's the most important part. But yeah, no, it definitely was up tilt because you could feel the crunchiness as well.
And back throw coming out from Crazy Colors. Again, high recovery coming out from Colonies. It's risky to do, but sometimes you just have to do it. It's obvious that Crazy Colors is looking to two-frame on the ledge if he chooses to side B and grab the ledge. But now, Luma's gone. This is I'm getting the roses confused. It's Colony's turn. Time to go in. Luma is gone, and we're just seeing all these options coming out from Colonies, but Colors just immediately getting out of the situation, simply rolling, choosing to use that instead.
Luma just pixels away from getting carted off the stage there by that last hit. This is, again, another super clutch situation, but is Colors going to be able to close it out? Colonies definitely does have that Cobra clutch, man.
Most definitely.
Yeah.
Most definitely. All this rage sitting on his side, he can definitely use it to his advantage. In a situation like that, there's a back air. Now he's hitting Luma, trying to bait a reaction, and gets grabbed. Instead, the up throw.
Wow.
Woof.
This is the most I've seen Rosalina kill with that move, for sure.
Right, it's you're 100%. You're too used to seeing up airs coming out of a Rosa player, and just see a throw do it. It's refreshing.
Yeah, definitely is. Okay, so it's gonna be 2-1 in favor of Crazy Colors 5, who's one game away from making it to winners finals right now. Definitely would be an upset in terms of the Ohio State power ranking. Of course, he is 3 spots lower than Colonies. Although, you know, it seems like this guy is really good.
Oh, he
is. I haven't seen Crazy Colors play for, I think, 3 years, but he's definitely impressed me. Or 2 years, rather.
All right, so we're heading back to Town of City for this game 4. Colonies down 2-1. Crazy Colors. Colors looking to take this 3-1, advance to winners finals, get that PR win, especially since this is the last day for our season 1 PR.
Oh, so, it is. Oh. Yep.
Try and get those wins, try and get those placements, and at this rate, he will be able to do it. And right there in that situation where Colonies went for the dare, that was the first time where Colors was able to grab him on the right side. He's been letting him get away with that a lot, but not that time.
And now we're seeing a kind of change in the narrative here. Colonies immediately just going straight for Luma, gets rid of her in the earliest exchanges of the game. And now he's got to keep that going. Basically, if he lets Crazy Colors reestablish himself here, all that momentum he just picked up is for naught.
He hasn't been able to get past that wall that is Luma. And again, he's going to eat those hits, but in the long run, it's going to pay off. Especially since you said, yeah, he has the lead now. He has the advantage. Immediate grab on that landing.
I like the perfect pivot in shield to account for Luma's presence there. And actually taking the first stock for the first time in this set, Colonies.
Just immediate walk-up grab from Colors.
Yeah, and no wait for the air dodge, too. I like that he's kind of playing his rock, paper, scissors game. Like, all right, this time I'm going to go for it immediately. But Colonies was ready that time.
There's
dash attack cancel grab. Keeping you locked into your shield. And then, of course, Rosalina comes behind with that guaranteed grab right afterward.
And we're starting to see a lot of nairs out of Colors. Not sure why. I mean, it's working out for him, most definitely.
And I think Colors' hesitance to go off the stage with down airs is actually costing him a lot of opportunities here. He could have killed Colonies 3-4 times already. That's 3 or 4 stocks that he gave up just because he wanted to be a little bit reserved with his edge guard. But I do like the pummels, buying time for Luma.
And definitely persistent play coming out from him, not wanting to really change it up. Maybe he just does not want to overextend like that. If he misses, he loses stage control. But at the same time, you really need to get rid of this stock now.
Right, and it's Fox, too.
Exactly, yeah. It's Fox.
Very exploitable recovery. But either way, Colony's now in the defensive seat, just able to play kind of the way he wants. But you can't – that's what I'm saying, man. Luma is such a thorn in Fox's side because, look at that, even up tilt doesn't send her away.
Probably should have went for jabs in that situation, would have kept Luma at bay and, as well, knocked him away.
Ooh, if he had just gone for turnaround grab, that would have been the set. I think turnaround grab on that platform, up throw, double up air, yeah, that would have been it.
Especially with the rage, and obviously get the Luma hits.
Yeah, I feel like a lot of people kind of freeze up when it's... Oh, my
like
God.
Like right there.
Yeah.
Oh, the dare into the up smash. So, Colony's pushing this to game 5. Very, very good conversion coming out on his part.
Yeah, reestablishing himself in the set, and it was really that fear factor. Most people just overlook the fact that you can just drop shield, turn around, and get whatever you want, but they're generally focused on trying to do some kind of out-of-shield option that hits from the back by default. So I think that really could have turned the tides there. Also, I just want to apologize about the whole Rosa up tilt thing. I swear I know what Rosa's up tilt looks like. I'm just definitely out of my element with all the traveling and working, so trust me, guys, I know that move.
That's understandable. I was confused as well. I mean... I'm getting Colors and Colonies confused because the C's, it's really messing me up.
And you got Karinol, Katakiri. You guys got all these C players. And
C's and K's.
Selja, Sylvanas, but those are, soft C's.
Jeez. So going to game 5. As for stages, I imagine running it back, probably either running it back to Town City or going back to Battlefield. Those are two main stages that we've seen so far. And I'd imagine we go back to Battlefield. To be honest,
it is a best of 5, so no Dave Stupid rule. So they could pick whatever they want, pretty much. But this is what we were talking about with the counterpick advantage. Now Crazy Colors gets to decide on which stage Game 5 is going to happen, which gives him a pretty significant advantage. Even though I think Fox and Rosalina don't necessarily have very many polarizing counterpicks against each other, I think, just being able to choose your comfort pick is huge. And also Colonies knows that, too.
Right. It's hard to say. We'll see in a moment here. They're obviously, they can't see right now, but their coaches are discussing with them, obviously, ways that they can do better over on this set. You have Karinol coaching Colors, and I believe that Sylvanas can't see him. I'm assuming that Sylvanas coaching. No,
oh,
that's
Carl's.
Another Fox player who's actually from Columbus, which is where both the Roses are from. So.
Oh, okay. So he's got that insider perspective, man. Martha Stewart went to jail for that. You should be careful. Yeah, so. It makes sense, though, that Karinol is going to be coaching Crazy Colors because they are teammates, or they were teammates at this event. They actually won doubles very handily.
They always team together.
Do they
always win? They're inseparable. Oh, goodness.
That's a scary team. I was thinking, like, man, why isn't Double Rosa more popular?
I mean, you don't normally see too many Rosas entered in tournaments, so. Too many.
Yeah,
not too many, honestly.
That's very true.
But anyways, taking this to Game 5. Game 5 situation on Dreamland.
I like this choice. I think it makes a lot of sense. Kind of adds some risk factor, of course, because Rosalina herself will die early. But compared to Battlefield, it's definitely a lot easier to crush those stocks at the super low percents with Luma's up air. So if he's able to make that happen, I'm looking forward to it. But it's looking like Colonies is just all over this man right now. Actually kind of adapting his strategy. I really like it. He's using down air rising down airs because the last hit will knock Luma into tumble no matter what.
Right, and he will auto-cancel out of the situation. Yes. And it's a mix-up on if he's going to land in front of or behind Colors. And he gets the air dodge read. But no, he just falls out of the up B. A good call from Colonies, but just slightly off the mark right there. Definitely would have took the stock, and it had only been a 1 minute so far.
That was almost like top 10 sickest things I've ever seen in Smash 4.
Jeez. Now he is forced to land. He's just constantly getting hit by these up tilts coming out from Colors. Able to land, but still gets thrown back up and air dodges out of the situation. Oh, jeez. Very risky plays coming out from Colonies.
Yeah, Colors picking the big stuff, too, going for forward smash on that side B read. If he had just gone for up smash or maybe an aerial, he would have had the punish for sure. Been able to maintain stage control, but it's looking like he's actually doing pretty okay anyway. He brought this all the way back.
All right, definitely can't count a character like Rosalina out of this, especially in the hands of a capable player like Colors.
Yeah, I gotta say, lots of underrepresented players on the national level here. Like, Crazy Colors is really good. You know, we've seen Colonies beat some top players because he gets to travel like that. And here's a guy that most people probably don't know, taking him to game five, super intensely close. What?
Oh my goodness.
Oh, that, no, he threw that way too early. I think he was anticipating the side B, but he should have known.
Oh, that time he actually goes off for the first time, but loses stage control and now forced to land.
Yeah, of course he does have to, you know, start making those attempts, but he also has to do it right.
Right.
Otherwise, it's not worth it.
Went at an angle there as opposed to going straight down, but those jabs were saying calmly straight up.
Yep, that was jab three for sure this
time. Yeah, all right, that was probably the first time we've actually seen him use the jab three at this percent. Rest of the time, just up tilt.
Colors, every time he presses jump, he's putting himself at actually severe risk of getting up aired.
There's a dash attack. Wow. He gets punished with an up smash. Colors waiting for that situation, and it pays off in the long run. And an up smash in rebuttal to Colors' up smash. It is even as can be right now.
That was such an intense little mind game session right there. First, I love how Colors used Luma as basically a bait. Hey, come hit her, Fox. I'm wide open. Nope. Whiff punish that dash attack. And then, right afterward, Colony smelled the fear in Colors' body. He's like, all right, there's an invincible Fox. I better get away from him. And Colony's knew and just chased him deep with his own up smash.
Right, we even seen earlier, right before Luma came back now, excuse me, he was actually able to get rid of Luma with the neutral getup. Very interesting. Immediately run up, grab. Does not get the hit to knock away Luma, but the back hit of dash attack will.
I love how Colonies just can detect this fear from Colors, and actually so scared that he dropped an easy punish on the platform. But all of a sudden, we've got both players at 69%. Rare moment in Smash.
Not some you see too often. All right, there's an up air. Got to watch out for Luma. He immediately got that situation. Air dodges to the second platform. Tries to read the landing with the up smash, but does not get punished.
Oh my goodness. Just another turnaround grab moment. Uh-oh, we see the down tilt out of the side B for the first time.
And Firefox actually going through the F smash. Luma F smash. Oh my goodness.
Both of these guys clearly making so many brilliant decisions and then just tiny little chokes that are costing them each the win here. Who is going to pull away with this? Who's going to winner's finals? Is it? No!
Oh, Luma,
not necessarily
Luma taking
yet.
The hits.
Okay, so we're going to see Colors revert back into defense mode.
Right, going to see a lot of dashes. Oh my goodness, and a lot of rolls coming out from Colors.
A lot of spaghetti as well. These Game 5 tense situations tend to lend themselves to that. Barely clinging to life after that back air.
Oh wow. My goodness, gets hit by the back air coming out from Colors. Side B's onto the stage. Does not choose to go after Luma. It's anyone's game. Pure pandemonium right now. There's the back throw coming out from Colonies. Going for a ledge trap. What's he going to do? Tries to F smash again, but regardless, Luma is gone.
A little bit of deja vu from that previous match.
There's a fourth throw. Definitely not going to go to timeout. There's only a minute, 30 seconds left on the clock. There's the F smash, reading the neutral getup, and Colony's able to clutch that out, advancing two winners' finals, 3-2. Oh my goodness, pure pandemonium right there. Oh.
Forward smash, definitely the MVP for Colonies in that set. That was actually kind of ridiculous, especially after game two, when they did have that moment where Luma froze the hitbox and extended it. Oh, man. Jeez.
That is one of his favorite ways to close out stocks on the ledge, especially if he's not given the opportunity to get those up airs.